Hey guys, welcome back to the next video. This time we're looking at the PCCOOLER RZ620 dual tower air cooler. Can it compete with Thermalright? Okay then, this is the RZ620. It is a CPU cooler from PCCOOLER. Big thank you to them for sending this out. Let's open it. Terms of specification, so that is what it supports: LJ 1200, 1500, and then of course 1700, AM4, AM5. That's the 6 heat pipes, that's the size of the actual product dimensions. It's black, of course. Fan dimensions, 120s. It's got a fluid dynamic bearing. They're the overall fan speeds, but there. And then of course, when it comes to the airflow, that's actually not bad. That's quite high fan pressure. That's actually quite good. The decibels, 32 is the high as it goes. And of course, it comes with all this beer. 3-year warranty, and it's 4-pin PWM. So let's open it. So yes, I've got a lot of products. I've actually received 4 from PCCOOLER. So I'm actually looking forward to this one. So first of all, we start with the accessory box. Now, I like the overall packaging, but of course not everyone will. Aha, here comes with the installation guide. This will tell you how to install it. This will tell you everything you need to know for AMD, Intel, and it'll also tell you how to install it as well as how to install the clips and how to actually, oh, so it does come with an adapter or a splitter. So, I like these little baggies by here. They're resealable, so you could, you know, there's no need to worry about it. And let's have a look at these accessories, shall we? Let's take them out. Ooh, I like shiny stuff. Right, so I like that. The back plate, that's for Intel. That is for, oh, that's a high performance. Looks got a little dongle there. But yeah, that looks cool. Right, so that's for Intel, AMD. They're the fan clips, and then that is the mounting. The mounting is much better than actual a lot of different brands. This is easy to install, very easy. So put that there, and of course it does come with their own thermal paste. I will be testing that as well to see how this is. So it's that thermal paste, the EX90. So it'll probably be within a couple of degrees of other pastes that coolers come with. So these are going to be the fans. Oh, these are exactly the same fans that comes with the DS360, and I really like these. So let's take the peel off. Look at that, that looks really nice. I like the overall, and they're all, look at that, they're also daisy chainable, which is very, very nice. So that's the fan, looks really nice. I like the fans. So let's get the cooler out, because that's one thing I really want to see. Okay, so let's get this cooler out. Oop, I really like the aesthetic so far. So, oh, ho-ho. Wow, I like that little little orange accent. Very similar to what Deepcool does. So the design of the heat pipes, very similar to what Deepcool does. I like the overall aesthetic on top. It does look rather striking. And with the fans, it will actually look really nice. So like it says, 6 heat pipes. There's the overall mounting system, but there. And then of course, it's got the base plate, which I would say it's actually quite small for Intel, but obviously I haven't got an Intel test bench, so I can't really tell, but that looks really small to me. But we will definitely get this on the test bench now and see how this performs. But aesthetically, I think it looks absolutely gorgeous. Okay, so this is the PCCOOLER RZ620. This is a 50% fan speed. I'm going to do it from about a foot away. And as you can hear, can't hear anything. Now, 100%. This is up close. And then this is from about a foot away. So yeah, so 100% you can't hear it, but at a foot away there should be a difference of, with the side panel on, you shouldn't be able to hear it that much. Okay then, so in terms of the overall benchmarking, I do use Cinebench R23, Blender Pavilion, Blender Classroom and 3D Mark CPTest because it does hit the CPU differently in different scenarios. Now, what I'm going to say is the CPU at the moment of testing, during all the tests, it did reach 185 watts. And the CPU I'm using is a Ryzen 9 5900X with PBO enabled. So for Cinebench R23, the idles are 33 Celsius with a max of 81. Blender Pavilion, idles 33, max 78 Celsius. Blender Classroom, idles 33 with a max of 77 Celsius. 3D Mark CPU test, the idles are 33 with a max of 71 Celsius. Okay, so look, you've seen the overall other parts of the video. Now, what I'm going to tell you short and sweet is the aesthetics, the overall look, the overall installation, and the overall packaging is there. The price, that is something that they need to try and work on. At the present moment on AliExpress, it's £51. If you want the white version, it's £53. Now, that is the main issue I have, is it is a little bit high. Now, if they want to compete with Thermalright, or Be Quiet, or any of the other cooler brands out there, they will have to bring down the price to be more competitive. Now, that's why Thermalright does so well, because they make great products for very good money. But, of course, the quality with some Thermalright products aren't there. Let's take the 120 Evo, for instance, the Phantom Spirit. Now, yes, aesthetically, it's absolutely stunning. I like the overall RGB, but the thing they have is with the overall cable management. The cable management on that cooler is a nightmare to actually make look tidy. At least with this one, it has pigtails for the PWM connectors, which I like. Now, it does have accents of orange on it. Now, this does have six heat pipes, the base plate. It's very, very similar to the Peerless Assassin. And probably what you saw through the overall comparisons for the benchmarks, this does either compete or beat it in some instances. So that says a lot. To beat Thermalright on the benchmarks, that does say a lot, but the problem is the price. If they can bring the price down a little bit, I'd say £40, then I think that they would actually be better. But they are going for more of the premium look, so I don't think that £51 or £50 is really that bad, considering there's a lot of other brands out there who try and sell for premium, and they put a premium price on it, and Thermalright absolutely kicks their butt. But this one, I think, will do okay in the UK market, because people love air coolers, and this one is very, very nice. So, look, I have got so much stuff to come in. There's a little sneak peek. This is a thermal camera. This will actually attach to my phone, and I'll be able to tell you what the overall thermal output of an air cooler is. Now, what this will show is how a heat pipe works. I will start incorporating this into my future videos, primarily with AIOs, to see which part of the AIO actually heats up. It's something cool for me to include, and something to be a little bit different than others. Not every reviewer actually includes a thermal, you know, an actual thermal part, a thermal recording to show you how the cooler actually heats up during workloads. So that's definitely something to keep your eye out for. Make sure you subscribe, because I've got loads of stuff coming here. I've got stuff here that I write from ID Cooling. I've got more PC cooler stuff. I've got stuff here from QNAP, which you probably saw from the previous video. I'm doing a NAS. I've got stuff coming from Seagate, from Toshiba. I've got a massive 45-inch ultra-wide game monitor from AOC. It'll be here tomorrow. I've got loads of stuff coming on, and also that I've just hit 1 million views on YouTube. So I'd like to say thank you to everyone. And this is Richard from WELSHYTECH. Goodbye.